Hey, what's up everyone, my name is Tulsiram and you're watching Codon. In this video I'll teach you how to use your old router, like this a D-Link old router, or you could use the Cisco or any of the router from any of the company and use it as a Wi-Fi extender. So in this video I have made the setup so that I can share my Wi-Fi from 30 meters away using a normal Ethernet cable and with the same username and user ID password. So let's get started. So before we begin the video, let me tell you one thing. You need to already have a Wi-Fi connection and a new router, because you are sharing the new router's internet with your old router and sharing at a far distance. So this is my old router. As you can see, there are different pins in the old router. So these are LAN cables and this is DSA cable. So we will be using the LAN cable to share the internet via very far distance. In this setup, let me show you. So this is the LAN that we will be connecting. It is already connected to my new router, which is 30 meters away from the existing floor. As you can see, I have set up the connection from here all the way to the ground floor. So my Wi-Fi setup is at the ground floor, so it goes down to my home. From here I'll be connecting this one single Ethernet cable to my old router. Well, this is the original router. As you can see, I am using the original router. This is via digital fiber cable, and this is the blue extender that we are using, which is connected at the top floor, which will be connected to another other router, that old one, so that it can be used as an extender. So after setting the ether cable from your new router to the place where you want to share your internet connection, now it's time to reset the router. So for resetting the router, as you can see, a router has different LAN setups which you can use, and the power supply. So every router has this reset button. It's called RST, as you can see. So connect the power supply, switch on the router. As soon as the router gets turned on, hold on to the reset button for 5 seconds. Take any pin or any sharp object. 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now after resetting the router, it will again restart it. As you can see, it will start restarting. It will take some time. Then the red light comes and it will restart. And after that, it will be an open Wi-Fi connection with this as the IP address and this is the username and password. You can see this information available in the box of your router, or it will mostly stick to the back with this slip and all the details written on it. Now this Wi-Fi connection is open with a D-Link as a Wi-Fi name. So after resetting your Wi-Fi router, now it's time to configure your old Wi-Fi router to act as a Wi-Fi extender. For that, you need to disable DHCP server. DHCP server is a connection server which will help you to connect the internet service provider's internet and your Wi-Fi router's internet, so that it can share the same internet between two server points. After you disable DHCP server, it will not ask for the connection or a new IP address. It will just share the existing IP address and use it for sharing the Wi-Fi internet. So for that, you need to connect to the router. Now the router will be an open connection. So D-Link is our open router connection. I'll just connect it. So now it's connected to D-Link. Now you need to go to your browser. Remember not to connect the Ethernet cable yet. We have to still configure. So go to 192.168.1.1 in any of the browsers. Click enter. It will ask for user ID and password. Admin, and admin is the user ID and password. Now click sign in. After that, you need to go to local networks, or in the setup option, it will be available that DHCP server. Click on that. After that, select mode, DHCP mode, and click none. What it does is it will disable the DHCP server. Now apply changes. After disabling the DHCP server, now it's time to change the IP address of the router, because you cannot use the same IP address for both the routers. So for that, go to local network and go to LAN interface. In that, you can see IP address is already visible. It's 192.168.1.1. So you can select from 2
to 254. I'll select it as 254 because no one will use 254. After that, apply changes. So after you do that, 192.168.1.254 is your new IP address for the old router. Now click on that. It will again ask for admin user ID and password, so click sign in. Now our Wi-Fi setup is completed. Now you can change the wireless name and change the security key so that you can use the same old Wi-Fi ID and password to sign in, or you can change, set up a new one. I'll set up a new one. If I go to Wi-Fi basics, it's already dealing. I'll change it to, okay, hold on. So that's our channel name, so subscribe to it if you like the video. Apply changes. After you hit the apply changes, it will take some time to restart and we'll configure the password for that. After changing the name, now it's time to connect your Wi-Fi router with the Ethernet cable. Now take the Ethernet cable.
After you have changed the name of the Wi-Fi router, take the router and connect it via Ether cable from the new router. Once you connect it, now the Wi-Fi is ready to set up the password for the Wi-Fi.
For that purpose, again you need to go to any one of the browser. Type 192.168.1.254, hit enter. Now it will again ask you for the username and password, which is admin and admin. Click sign in. Now go to the local network setup, internet setup, and go to wireless security. Now select one of the security options that you already have. The best option is WPA2 AES, which is best and it's not easy to hack. Now change the password. I'll do work Wi-Fi. So it's work Wi-Fi. Now apply changes. Once that is done, now your Wi-Fi router is totally set up with a security key. After that, it will restart after some time and your internet setup is completed. Now after it gets restarted, I'll show you that you are able to access internet. Now as you can see, we are connected to Codon's internet. It says Codon 2. When you restart it, it will again change its name to Codon. This is just a temporary. Now I'll search for studio.youtube.com. I'll see if I can access internet or not. So once you reconnect to the Wi-Fi connection, as you can see, now you are able to access internet and share your new Wi-Fi internet with your old router and extend it to a large distance. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and comment what kind of topics you want me to make videos on so that I can share you more information and help you. That's it for today, and see you guys in the next one. Till then, peace.